In the first episode of the series, I showed you how you can construct your own catapult, and I showed you how to construct the base, the frame, the nest that holds the brick, and the lever that fires the small Lego parts. The whole catapult uses only the gravity force, but it was not very stable. And in this video, I would like to show you how you can improve the stability of the base and in the same time achieve this free turn of the catapult. Now let's think about the problem for a moment. In our current construction from the first video, you can throw fire a small Lego part, and as you can see, the whole construction is not very stable when firing. It moves, it might fall. Probably if the brick was heavier, it might even fall. A good way to enhance the base of the robot is to use frames. These frames are available in the EV3 version of the robot and in some of the newer NXT version. So we can find different ways to attach those frames and to enhance the base, to increase the surface of the base. For example, I've prepared this construction, very, very simple. And if I attach some of the frames in such a way, we do achieve a kind of a larger frame. And we can now add the whole catapult to this larger base, and probably we will improve the stability of the robot. But the problem is actually not only to improve the stability of the robot, but to make it turn freely on a random degree. For this, we could use a part that's available only in the NXT version. So if you have an EV3 version of the robot, you have to go with the small base. But if you have an NXT version of the robot, you can improve this with this wheel, gear wheel, and we could add this at the bottom of the robot. Here it is. So, as a last step, if we find a way to attach the whole catapult to this wheel, we'll be able to turn it freely. I've prepared the pins, and now we just add the construction on top, and we could, of course, think of ways to attach it. Like this. These are only examples. You can find different ways. And the whole process of attaching the robot and enhancing the base would look something like just attached on one side and then on the other side. Here's the attachment, the whole catapult attached to the geared wheel, and the geared wheel attached to the enhanced larger base. And it would now be much more stable, and it would be much more difficult for the catapult to fall. Now we have the base, and it's quite stable. We can fire different small, not very heavy Lego parts. We can turn the robot. But there's one more thing that we should improve in the base. I'll detach the catapult from the base. And as you can see, we would like to achieve something very stable. but all the frames in the base are connected in only one direction, which means that the whole base, it bends. And when it bends, it's not very stable. I've forgotten a part here to it, but you will have this in the construction, and the whole base will be very unstable. One of the ways to fix this, and you should always fix this in each of your construction, is to add some parts that would prevent this bending. And we could add the parts in the following way. In this way, we make the whole construction much more stable without bending, and it will be suitable for our catapult. As you can see, it's not that fragile. And now we add the catapult. Attached from one side and from the other, and we have our very, very stable construction. In the next video, we'll continue with adding a motor and a sensor so that the whole process of loading the catapult and firing is completely automatic.